us, Isu just of the cross. If ties royal banner, it must not suffer loss. From victory to victory, his army shall be lead. Till every foe is vanquished, and Christ is Lord indeed. Sadab, sadab for Jesus, the trumpet call obey, for to the mighty conflict in this is glorious day. He that a man has having against an abad force, the courage rise with danger, and strength to strength oppose. Sadab, sadab for Jesus, stand in his strength alone. The arm of flesh you fail you, he dare not trust your own. Put on the gospel armor, and watching unto prayer, where do
God is good, and all the time. Hebu tuombe. Heavenly Father, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we come before thy throne of mercy with thanksgiving in our hearts, Jehovah God. Thank you for this wonderful morning, Jehovah God, that you have enabled us to assemble once again in your holy house to worship you and to praise you. Want to thank you because of your love and your mercies upon each and every one of us, O God. We really want to thank you because of your faithfulness and the grace that you've bestowed upon us, O God, that this morning we have the gift of life, we are in good health, and you are here, Jehovah God, to pour our hearts unto you. Heavenly Father, we commit this service unto your able hearts, O God, that as we begin, O God, begin with us, and Jehovah God, may you minister to us through your Holy Spirit. We commit the leader of the service unto your able hearts, the preacher of the word, the choir as they lead us in songs, the praise and worship team, and every one of us, O God, as we climb up in your mountain, Jehovah God, we are expectant of you and you are waiting to receive great things from you. May you bless us, O God. May you meet us at our point of need. Minister to us this morning. Heavenly Father, we commit ourselves to you, believing and trusting that you'll be with us as we begin and as we end this service. Heavenly Father, we commit ourselves to you. This is our humble prayer of faith through Jesus Christ, our Lord. So today is the Nazareth group that are reading us. So we now welcome you to begin the service.
Good morning and welcome to today's service. I tell you, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over all sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who do not repent. I will set out and go back to my father and say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. The Lord be with you. We have come together, the people of God, drawn by his spirit, longing for his word, to praise the holy name of the Lord, to share his glorious news of grace, to pray for our needs and the pain of the world, to rejoice in love and be sent in his peace. We are heirs of the Father, renewed in the Spirit. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins in repentance and trust, God is faithful and just, and will forgive us our sins. So let us confess them to our Father. Together. Father, God of our ancestors, before you called the trouble, but through your Son you approach your throne. Yes, in our hearts. Lord have mercy, condemn not against us.
Grant us the joy of forgiveness, enlighten our hearts.
To the glory of Christ, who died and rose again. The Lord of mercy, grant us your pardon and peace that cleanse from our sins, and with your peace in our hearts, we may be free to serve you through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are those who live in your house.
We will always be singing your praise.
The name, praise the Lord.
The name of the Lord be praised.
Glory to the Father in whom all things began.
Glory to the Son who became the Son of Man. Glory to the Spirit who inspires and renews. The Lord our God forever. Hallelujah.
Now we'll hear the jubilee song from the choir.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice for he has made me glad. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. Hallelujah.
Have our seats and listen to the first reading.
Yendembele injilia. Yendembele injilia Yesu. Yendembele.
Morning, church. I'm James Hinga, and the first reading is coming from the book of Proverbs, chapter 1, verse 4. Then verse 22 to 31. Does not wisdom call out? Does not understanding raise her voice? On the heights along the way, where the path meets, she takes her hand beside the gates leading into the city. At the entrance, she cries loud, "To you, O men, I call out. I raise my voice to all mankind." Verse 22. The Lord brought me forth as the first of his works, before his deeds of old. I was appointed from entity from the beginning, before the world began, when there were no oceans, I was given birth, where there were no springs abounding
the water, before the mountains were settled in place, before the hills I was given birth, before he made the earth or its fields or of any dust of the world. I was there when he set the heavens in place, when he marked out the horizon on the face of depths, when he established the clouds above and fixed securely the fountains of the depth, the deep, when he gave the sea its boundaries, so the water would not overstep his command, and when he marked out the foundation of the earth, then I was the craftsman at his side. I was filled with delight day after that, rejoicing always in his presence, rejoicing in his whole world and delight in mankind. That marks the end of the first reading.
Choir.
Moto moto injili yo.
Moto moto.
Moto moto.
Thank you.
Let's clap for them. Now we listen to our second teaching.
Inasonga mbele njili, inasonga. Inasonga mbele njili, inasonga mbele.
Good morning, church. My name is Peter Gitao, and I will take us through our second reading. Our second reading comes from the book of John, chapter 21, from verse 1 to 9. John chapter 21, from verse 1 to 9. And I start. Afterward, Jesus appeared again to his disciples by the Sea of Tiberias. It happened this way. Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two other disciples were together. I'm going out to fish, Simon Peter told them. And they said, we'll go out with you. So they went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. Early in the morning, Jesus stood on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. He called out to them, friends, haven't you had any fish? No, they answered. He said, throw your net on the right side of the boat and you will find some. When they did, they were unable to haul the net in because of the large number of fish. Then the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, it is the Lord. As soon as Simon Peter heard him say, it is the Lord, he wrapped his outer garment around him, for he had taken it off, and jumped into the water. The other disciples followed in the boat, towing the net full of fish, for they were not far from the shore, about 100 yards. When they landed, they saw a fire of burning coals there with fish in it and some bread. That marks the end of our first reading.
We stand together with Christians throughout the centuries and throughout the world to affirm our faith in the world of the Apostles' Creeds. I believe in God. I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He sat at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Choir.
Ask and it shall be given unto you. Seek and you shall find. I knock and the door shall be opened unto you.
Savior taught us, we are bold to pray. Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Show us your mercy, O Lord. O Lord, guide our president. May your ministers serve you faithfully in the valley of the shadow of death. Like trees planted by the waterside, send us out as the salt of the earth. May the earth be filled with your glory. prayer for the day.
How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Today is Trinity Sunday. Let us pray. Holy Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, we worship you, adore you, and put all our faith in you. Help us ever to abide by this faith and zealously defend it, for it is eternally abiding. Through the merits of our Savior Jesus Christ, who reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, days without end. This is our humble prayer of faith through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray together the first article of peace. Almighty and everlasting God, Father of the Prince of Peace, in turning and rest we are saved. In quietness and trust is our strength. Grant us the blessing of making peace and the joy of seeking justice. Take from our souls all strain and stress, and let our other lives confess the beauty of your peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now we will welcome the praise and worship, accompanied by the Nazareth. And our mother will lead us in the intercessory prayers.
There is something today in the house of the Lord. There is something today in the house of the Lord. There is something today in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, today in the house of the Lord. There is praising today in the house of the Lord. There is praising today in the house of the Lord. There is praising today in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah,
today. There is praising today in the house of the Lord.
There is praising today in the house of the Lord.
Praising today in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, today in the house of the Lord. Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of my praises today. Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of my praises today.
Jesus,
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 Bwana kama wewe
kama wewe
Bwana
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 Yesu
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 Uro. Bwana wa mabwana pewe sifa
pewe sifa Mungu wetu leo pewe sifa Bwana wa mabwana
goro ya kwanera kana goro ya kwela tumba tumba goro ya kweka iwawe ka iwawe ne todo wa mono pia igwali horo wa wedo Otare morugo yene modo ni wedo wa magenga yea
wedo wa wedo
wedo yonyete zwonge jeso otare morugo yene modo ni wedo wa magenga yea
goro ya kwanera kena
goro ya kwela tuma tuma goro
Thank you.
Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth, we humble ourselves before thee this beautiful day with thanksgiving and adoration from deep within our hearts, O Lord. We proclaim and decree that you are Ebenezer in our lives. Indeed, we've seen you working in our lives. Indeed, we've seen you holding our hands and walking with us, O God. This far, it has only taken your mighty hand. If we say that we've not seen, for sure we are not truthful to our words, O God. We pray that you may kindly watch over us with your sympathetic eye. That you may kindly forgive us from each and every sin that we may have committed. May you have your way in our hearts. May you have your way in our lives. That you may take your place, O Lord. Because we decree and declare that alone we can never make it, O God. But when you walk with us, my Redeemer Savior, for sure we are going to be victorious. That is what we pray for this beautiful morning, my Redeemer Father. Almighty God, thank you so much for gifting us with the gift of life. Thank you so much for giving us good health, oh Lord. It is a blessing, it is a favor that we surely don't take for granted. Thank you for giving us good mental health, oh God. There are people out there who are crying day and night, oh God, wondering what it will become of them, my Redeemer Father. For sure, there is nothing good that we've done that we can say this is the reason that we are because this morning, my Redeemer God. But for sure, we are because you are, oh Lord. May you find your place in our hearts. May you find a place in our lives, oh God. May you kindly be seen that we may lack, oh God. Because when you illuminate in us, my Redeemer Father, the radiation is not comparable, oh God. At this moment, we thank you so much. Thank you for giving us the strength to come to your home, to your church, oh God. It is a blessing. We decree and declare that we are blessed ones of you, oh God. We decree and declare that we are not going to live the same way we came in this church, oh God. May you give us a revival in our lives. May you give us a revival in our work of places, oh God. May you give us a revival in our families, oh God. Everything that we are trusting in you, oh God, may you help us to trust in thee. May you help us to put our hope and trust in thee, oh God. Because you're never late and you never come too early, oh God. May you help our hearts to be patient, my Redeemer God. There is none like you. There is none to be glorified and to be worshipped as you, O God. Thank you so much because of the blessings that you bestowed on us, O God. We've seen you blessing our country, O God, giving us peace, giving us joy and unity, O God. Even at times in the political arena, O God, we pray that you may give each and every single person who is in the authority, my Redeemer God, may you give them your wisdom and justice. May you give them your wisdom and knowledge, that in each and every single decision making that they are doing, O God, may they be guided of you, O Father. Thank you so much, my Redeemer Savior. We've seen you calming the rains, my Redeemer God. We thank you and we adore you, O Father. At this specific moment, we pray for those people who are afflicted, O God. May you kindly visit them in a special way, O God. May you kindly be on their listening, that you may come to their rescue in Jesus' mighty name. We pray that you may kindly remember those people who are going through thick and thin. Others are sick. Others we cannot even comprehend whatever they are going through, oh God. You who sees in secret, we pray.
pray that you may kindly visit them in a special way in Jesus' mighty name. May you kindly bind their lives. May you kindly plant a new song in their lives this morning in Jesus' mighty name. Even at this moment, we remember those people who are ailing. May you stretch your gracious power, that hand which healeth, oh God. We decree and declare that they are healed of you in Jesus' mighty name. There may be a person who is ailing in our midst, my Redeemer Father. May you stretch your healing power. My Redeemer Savior, there are other people who have been left by their loved ones, oh God. You who sees the deepest sorrow, oh God. We call upon your holy mighty name this beautiful morning, my Redeemer God. May you kindly wipe away their tears. May you kindly have your way in that gap which has been left behind, oh God. And when you're going to do that, all the glory and honor shall be back unto thee. Even at this moment, we remember our roads, my Redeemer God. Those places which has been proclaimed as dark spots, oh God, we decree and declare that your blood has power to change names, oh God. We decree that our roads are blessed of you, oh God. We pray and know and trust that you are not going to sing the song of accident in Jesus' mighty name. We remember the afflicted families, oh God. Many are in tears for the premature deaths, my Redeemer God. For the deaths which are coming not prepared for, oh God. May you kindly have your way in their lives, oh Father. There is none like you, oh God. There is none to be glorified as you, oh God. That's why we humble ourselves before you this beautiful moment, oh God. To just say thank you. We are just privileged. We are just honored. Because for sure there's nothing that we've done, oh God. At this moment we thank you so much because of blessing us with the fruit of our wombs, oh God. As families we thank you for our children, oh God. Especially for those who are schooling in the boarding schools, oh God. For sure we've had a lot of accidents, but we've not had one of our own, oh God. What compares to that, my Redeemer God? May you kindly continue protecting our children back at school, oh God. May you continue binding them with your favor, my Redeemer Father. May they be the head and not the tail, my Redeemer God. We commit those schools unto your able mighty hands. We know that they are going to learn and they are going to finish victorious in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you so much even for those who are going to school each and every single morning, oh God. We've seen your hand. We've seen your grace and your mercy, oh Father. May you continually remind us to be thankful to thee, oh God. You're holy and you're worthy, oh Father. At this moment, we thank you so much even for our church, my Redeemer God. We remember our bishop, my Redeemer Father. May you kindly continue guiding him and showing him your ways, oh God. May you give him your wisdom and also your knowledge in everything that he does, oh God. Each and every single person who is working under him, my Redeemer God, we pray that you may bless them in accordance to your able ways, oh God. At this moment, we remember our St. Max Mokoi, oh Father. Thank you for our area dean, Grace, oh God. May you continually bless her and guide her to your righteous path, oh Father. We thank you for her life in this sanctuary, my Redeemer God. May you bless her together with her family, my Redeemer Father. Whenever they come to thee, may you kindly be on their listening, my Redeemer Father. Whenever that she may feel like it is so hard for her, may you come to her rescue, my Redeemer God. Thank you also for our evangelist, my Redeemer God. He is a blessing to this sanctuary, my Redeemer God. May you bless him together with his family, my Redeemer God. Bless them, O Lord. Let them, whenever they call unto your name, may you always be on their listening and answer their prayers, my Redeemer God. We thank you for our lay leaders. We thank you so much even for the PPC, my Redeemer God. May you bless them as they plan for the betterment of this church in Jesus' mighty name. Even as a congregation, we bring forth ourselves to thee. May each and every single thing that we commit to, O God, may it be for the glory and for the honor of your holy mighty name. Because for sure we cannot make it alone, O God. Let everything that we do, O God, glorify you, O Lord. Thank you so much, my Redeemer Father. You've given us a preacher of today, O God. May you bless her now. May you guide her. May you kindly give her your word, O God. Even as she passes it to us, O God, may it be for the glory and honor of your holy mighty name, O Lord. At this moment, we commit even the leader of the service. We commit each and every single thing that is going to be done in your sanctuary. And for sure, when we are going to see the end of it all, we are going to say that you're holy and you're worthy. And now it is in your special mighty name that we've prayed with that shortly believing and trusting. Amen and amen.
Let's clap for the people of Nazareth. Now we'll listen to the notices.
Good morning, church. Praise God. I'm also fine. Today is the last Sunday of May 26th, and we have Nazareth who are leading us. We welcome all of you this Trinity Sunday. On behalf of the PCC and the area dean, we welcome you all. Do we have any visitors? Anyone fellowshipping with us for the first time? Or anyone who has been away and they are fellowshipping with us today? Okay, we don't seem to. So we welcome all of you and thank you so much for choosing to fellowship in St. Mark's Church, Mukoi. We also would like to take this opportunity to welcome our online viewers. Feel appreciated, and we are very grateful. Today, we are celebrating birthdays of all born in the month of May. And I hope you are all prepared. Last Sunday was DMA Sunday, and we thank you for the support that you gave to them. Thank you for the continuous support that you have continued to give towards the Mushada project. We have collections for last Sunday. The English service was able to raise 5,470, and the Kikuyu service was able to raise 11,700, giving us a total of 17,170, and that is inclusive of the pay bill payments that come through the pay bill. We'll have the stone collection done after this, and then you are also requested to to kindly register for the stone collection for the coming months. There are people who had registered for last month, and now the list that we had is over. So I would also request you to register immediately after service out there. Kindly register for the stone collection. We also appreciate our online contributors for the generous contributions that they have continued to give. Feel appreciated, and we are very, very grateful. We have managed a good collection of funds due to the Sunday's stone collections, and we urge you to continue giving generously. Let us continue with the fundraising preparations of the 7th of July fundraising. Kindly continue to support giving your contributions and pledges, and this is being done through the cell groups, so kindly continue doing the same. As we have always said, our target is 50 million, and so your support is highly recommended. The Senior Citizen Fellowship will be held here in the church on Thursday, that will be on the 30th, starting at 10 a.m. The Senior Citizen Fellowship on Thursday, starting at 10 here in the church. Those who wish to have their children or they wish to be baptized, to see the PCC members in the course of the coming month. We have an announcement from the Mothers Union Department. All mothers are requested to meet briefly in the church, and this will be after the Kikuyu service. So for the English service members, kindly come back after the Kikuyu service to meet the chairperson, and it will be a very brief meeting. The Mothers Union Wednesday Fellowship will be held here in the church starting at 3 p.m. Kindly all mothers, papas to attend. The youth will be leading us on the first Sunday of June. That will be on the 2nd of June. And these are universities and colleges students. So kindly meet after the service so that you can make those preparations. I believe it's coming Sunday, so you need to up your game. So kindly meet after the service so that you can do those preparations. We wish to thank you all for the overwhelming support that you have given so far for our fellow Christians who were affected by the floods. Feel appreciated, and we are very, very grateful. The teens service is being held every Sunday, starting at 10 a.m. in the old church. Their Holy Communion Sunday is second Sunday of every month, and so we urge all parents with teens to encourage them to attend. The fellowship, cell group fellowships, Bethlehem will have their fellowship at Mama Brian's. And also we ask all the cell groups to meet after the service to discuss and prepare for the fundraising that is coming up on the 7th. The youth are also being asked to meet after the service. St. Mark's Mokoi Sako are notifying us that they'll hold an AGM on the 8th of June this year in the church boardroom. And a notice of the meeting will be sent to all the registered members. Kindly continue to confirm your membership with Beth Kamau if you didn't do so last Sunday. We have an announcement from Honorable Gidhua Wamashukuru. This is about the issuance of the bursary checks for the year 2024 for colleges, universities, and persons living with disabilities. The checks will be issued on Thursday, 30th May, 2024. There's a change we had announced earlier that it was going to be this Tuesday, but there are changes. So this will be done on Thursday, 30th, at Kerangare Primary School in the morning at 8 a.m. and then at Gathega Primary School at 2 p.m. Kindly, parents who had applied for those bursaries, note those changes. On Thursday, 30th May, at Kerangare Primary School, that will be in the morning at 8, and then Gathega Primary School at 2. There is also a National Agriculture Value Chain Development Project notifying us that there will be a meeting, Baraza, on Friday 31st, and this will be done at Karura Kanyongo Primary School at 2 p.m. National Agriculture Value Chain Development Project are calling us for that Baraza on Friday 31st at 2 p.m. at Karura Kanyongo Primary School. Jerusalem Fellowship today at Ann Jonge's home. Kindly, Jerusalem members, join for the fellowship today at Ann Jonge's place. We have a death announcement. The family of Jidra Mbogwa Kevugi Kanamistri are notifying us of the death of Mary Wamboi, Mary, and they are requesting us to join them today for the lamentation service at their home in Gathega near Matagima Gathega, Munadaini. Burial details will be given to us later. Kindly join that family of Jidraf Mbogwa Kevugi today for the lamentation service for the demise of their mother, Mary Waboi Kanameri. I have some letters here. This Patrick Kongo is being notified to visit the post office. There's a letter that they need to pick. Patrick Kongo will pick this paper and you'll be able to pick your letter at the post office. I have a letter for Nelly Nyamadwe Kamau, Susan Washeke Kamau, Mary N. Kamau, and Jogu Roda Mukami, and then also Abigail Kingili. There's a card for you. If you know Abigail or it is yours, kindly visit the festry after this and you can pick your letters. My name is Jane Gikonyo and I love the Lord as my personal savior. God bless you as we continue with the service.
Let us clap for her. Now we welcome the person who's collecting the stone. Praise God, church. Praise God again. My name is Michelle Joaquin Jeroge from the Nazareth Child Group, and I am a born-again Christian. So today, as we collect the stone, I have this verse with me, 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6. Remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. So let us be reminded that today, as we give towards the building of the Mushada project, that we are doing this all for the glory and honor of God. And the little or the much that you have is very much appreciated. Now let us welcome every one of us to give whatever he or she has decided with their hearts. Thank you and welcome. Choir, kindly lead us with that number.
ya bariki injilio, ya bariki injilia Yesu, ya bariki. Ndiyo mana tunasema yende mbele, ndiyo mana tunasema yende mbele. Mana tunasema yende mbele. Studio, you could also kindly, if you could kindly share the paybill number for those who are giving via M-Pesa. Thank you.
Moto 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 injili ya Yesu, moto 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 injili yo, moto 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 injili ya Yesu, moto moto. Ndiyo mana tunasema yende mbele, ndiyo mana tunasema yende mbele, ndiyo mana tunasema yende mbele. Ndiyo mana tunasema yende mbele.
Thank you all for giving and may God bless you all.
Now we welcome the people who have tithes or any form of thanksgiving. Welcome.
He has done me well. He has done me well. He has done me well, Jesus. He has done me well. He has done me well. He has done me well, Jesus. He has done me well. He has done.
Praise the Lord. Just to remind ourselves what Joki has just quoted, 2 Corinthians chapter number 9. If you read from verse 6 down to verse 11, verse 6, the Bible says that whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. That whoever sows generously will also reap generously. That each man should give what he or she has decided in his heart to give, not reluctantly or under any compulsion. For God loves a cheerful giver. If you read verse 8, the Bible says that, and God is able to make all grace abound to you, so that in all things at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. So it is our prayer that Jehovah God will make you abound in every good work. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, bless these, your dear servants, who have publicly come to acknowledge your goodness and your love and your mercies towards them. They have come, Jehovah God, to worship you with their tithes and with other forms of thanksgiving. Deep from their heart, O God, they can confess of your goodness towards them, and they are here to declare your love and your mercies unto them. How we pray, O God, that you may continue to be with them, that you may continue to be their going out and their coming in. We pray that, Jehovah God, you may bless the work of their hearts. Heavenly Father, may you continue to show them your love and your mercies, shower them with more blessings. All that they are and all that they have is yours. In gratitude, Jehovah God, they have come to offer to you from their businesses, from their employment, from their farms, and from other sources of income that you have blessed them with. They are here, Jehovah God, to offer thanks to you. May you accept their gifts, O God, and bless it, O God, for the furtherance of your work and propagation of your work in this parish and beyond. How we pray that, Jehovah God, you may continue to bless them, O God, that you may continue to establish their work and multiply it, that they may have more to meet their various needs and more to bring to your work. How we pray that, Jehovah God, you may make them rich in every way, so that they can be generous in every occasion, and that their generosity will result in thanksgiving to you. How we pray that, Jehovah God, you may continue, King of all the glory, to supply more seeds unto them. Continue to supply more bread for food to them and to their families. How we pray that, Jehovah God, you may continue to supply and increase the store of their seeds. May you enlarge the harvest of their righteousness, that they may continue to see you in everything that they do. We commit them to you, O Jehovah God, and we declare they are blessed of you. Now we commit them to you, O God, and we declare the words of Numbers chapter 6, verse 24 to 26. May you bless them, O God. May you make your face shine upon them, O God. Heavenly Father, may you turn your face toward them and give them peace. Be gracious to them in all their endeavors. This is our humble prayer of faith through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord God Almighty bless you and continue to keep you. God bless you.
Being the last Sunday of the month, we welcome the May babies. Karibuni.
Tumshukuruni Bwana kwa kuwa ni mwema, kwa maana fadhili zake ni za milele. Tumshukuruni Bwana kwa kuwa ni mwema, kwa maana fadhili zake za milele. Mshukuruni Bwana kwa kuwa ni mwema, kwa maana fadhili zake ni za milele.
Let us pray for these dear ones. Heavenly Father, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, I want to thank you because of your great love and mercies that you've shown these your dear servants who have come to your holy altar to worship you and to praise you and to give you thanks. As your word records in Psalm 71, verse 6 to 8, from birth they have relied on you. You brought them forth from their mother's womb, and Jehovah God, you've continued to be their strong refuge. And they are in this holy altar to declare your splendor all day long. And their mouths are filled with praise to worship you and to honor you. Lord, you've continued to be their strong refuge. Your faithfulness has been their shield and their rampart. Lord, you have shown them mercy, and therefore they have every reason to praise you and to honor you. How we pray, O God, that you may continue to protect them from the devourer. May you protect them from the foreign snare. May you protect them from the deadly pestilence. How we pray that, Jehovah God, you may continue to see them through together with their families. They were born in different years, in different days, in the month of May. And here, Jehovah God, they are declaring your splendor, for they have confession, and they are witnesses of what God you can do. You have seen them through in different areas, ups and downs. You've been together with them. We pray that you may cover them and shield them with your love and your mercies. May you cover them under your wings. Let them find refuge in all their endeavors, O God. We commit them to you. How we pray that Jehovah God, you may continue to shower them with your blessings. Any prayer request that they have before thy throne of mercy, God, meet them and continue to supply to them according to your riches in glory. Now they are here with the gifts to thank you and to honor you. May you accept their gifts as they celebrate a new year. And now, Jehovah God, we pray for more of your grace, more of your favor to accompany them, and we declare they are blessed of you. May you, Jehovah God, now bless them. May you pour on their laps a good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and overrunning with your blessings. More years of God's grace and favor is their portion today. And Jehovah God, we declare Psalms 91, verse 16. May you satisfy them with long life and show them your salvation. This is our humble prayer of faith through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord God Almighty, bless you now. May you receive your gifts as the choir leads us with the happy birthday song. Receive your gift in Jesus' name. God bless you. Receive your gift in Jesus' name. God bless you.
Happy birthday,
God bless you. More years of God's grace and favor.
Happy birthday,
more years of God's grace and favor. 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 God bless
you. May you have many, many more. May you have many, many more. May you have many, many more. Birthday to you, happy birthday, dear loved ones.
Because of time, we will bring our free will offering and welcome our preacher as we sing hymn number 101.
Just as I am without one blame, but that my blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. I come. Just as I am and waiting not to rid my soul of one dark blot, to thee whose blood can cleanse its spot, O Lamb of God, I come. I come. Just as I am, though tossed about with many a conflict, many a doubt, fighting and fears within, without, O Lamb of God, I come. I come. Just as I am, poor wretch and blind, sight reaches healing of the mind. Ye are
Praise God, everyone. Praise God again. You may have your seats. Let us bow our heads for a word of prayer. Almighty, ever-living God, most gracious Father, we are before your holy presence this wonderful morning with thanksgiving at heart for this time that you've given unto us to listen to your word and to meditate upon it, O God. But Father God, as I teach your word to your people, O God, may it also minister to my heart and to my soul, O God. How I pray and how we pray the Lord, you may guide us and may you help us to listen to your word. For it is in Jesus' name we do pray, believe, and trust in your holy name. Praise God. Praise God again. The joy of the Lord is my strength this morning. As I stand before you this morning, I want to thank our area dean for this opportunity to stand in her pulpit to minister the word of God to you, to us, and to God. Thank you also for the Nazareth team for giving me this opportunity to speak the word of God. Yes, this morning I'm Hannah Wangui Kamau, old teacher Hannah. More to that, I'm born again. And the Lord has been the source of joy to my life. Standing this morning here, I take it as a gift from God. If it were for a man or for men, I would not be here this morning. But God saw it right for me to be alive this day. We are going to hear the word of God as I teach. I am a teacher, so I'll teach the word of God and hope that it will minister to us. As it ministers to me, it will also minister to you. Amen? And I will request the studio to give us the first slide. Yes. Today, I want us to learn about being still and letting God fight our battles. Amen? Being still and letting God fight our battle. Then we ask ourselves in the next slide, what is to be still? I hope everyone can see that. What is to be still? And it says it is to let go, to release. In short, it means surrender. It is entrusting our lives, our plans, and our future into God's capable hand. Amen? Being still, entrusting our lives unto God's plan and our future unto God, because he's capable. When you're still, you are able to release yourself to God, and you're able to surrender unto God. Surrender is freely letting go. You let go of anything and you let God take control. Amen? Yeah, and we are guided from the book of Psalms 46:10, where it says, "Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth." Amen? Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. Be still. The word, the psalmist was encouraging himself with this word, that I will be still and know that God will reign in my life and will be exalted over my life. Amen? And also, in the book of 1 Samuel 12:16, and it says, verse 16, "Now then, stand still and see this great thing the Lord is about to do before your eyes." Now then, stand still and see this great thing the Lord is about to do before your eyes. It was somewhere encouraging the people of Israel. When you read the book of 1 Samuel 12 from the start, it was when Samuel was giving the mantle to a king. the king that they had requested from God. And the Israelites had gone through so much at that time, and he encouraged them with those words. Now then, stand still and see this great thing the Lord is about to do before your eyes. Let this verse speak unto us that we should be still and let God do something new in our eyes. When you are still and when you trust in God upon his word, he's able to make you see a good thing before your eyes. Amen? We go. Then we are learning, how can we practice stillness in God's presence? How can we all practice this stillness in God's presence? And the first point I learned, listening to and singing praise and worship songs. When you listen to songs that of praise and worship, you're able to be filled with a kind of comfort in your heart. That is that stillness. You're able to get that stillness in your heart. And I'm always led by this song, oh, I will be still and know you are God. I will be still and know you are God. You can also go home and listen to the song. It's by Hillsong Worship. Then the second thing we can also do to have stillness in our lives, in God's presence, follow a daily Bible reading plan. Sometimes you only read the Bible when you feel like. But the moment you read the Bible every day, the moment you have a plan on how to read the Bible, the moment we are able to read the Bible every day, we are filled with that stillness in our heart. We are able to surrender our all unto God, because we will be able to understand who God is over our life. Then the next, you can also take a prayer walk. Yes, when going to work, you can decide one day not to drive to work. If you drive to work, just walk in the matatu. You can pray to God. You can also take a vacation, go to Karura Forest as you walk, and have a prayer time with God. It's not only, prayer is not only in your house or seated somewhere. You can take that prayer walk. You can be able to grow in stillness in the presence of God when you take a prayer walk. Amen? Then we are also going to learn, how do we let God fight our battle? We have learned about stillness. We have learned how to be still and how to exercise this stillness and how to grow this stillness before the presence of God. Now we are going to see, how do we let God fight our battle? The battles you have in, how do you let God fight your battle? And the first point I got, he goes before us, making a way. When you let God go before you and make a way for you, you are letting him fight your battle. Sometimes we try to justify ourselves and say that I will do this to get this, but God is encouraging us that we let him make a way for our life. That is, he will be able to fight that battle you have in your life. Then the second point, he promises to fight for us. He's promising us, when we let him take control, he's able to fight for us. When we turn our hearts to him and seek his voice, that is pour out our helplessness to him. When you pour out yourself unto God, he's able to fight your battles. But he can't fight your battles if you are not pouring them out to him. If you keep telling other people, I'm going through this, but you're not letting God know. You're not letting God, you are not pouring your heart out to God. He will not fight your battle. But when you pour yourself out unto God, he's able to fight your battle. The third point, let him move against our enemies, those wounds of heart, confusion, and fear that we might have in our lives. Enemies here, they're not just people, but enemies are those things that you can face in your life. You can get hurt when you're walking, you can be driving, then you get an accident. But when you let him move in all those times that you have, when you let him move in your confusion. You know, sometimes we can be confused. I don't know what to do with my life. I wake up in the morning, I don't have a job, I'm done with my school, I don't know what I'm going to do next. But when you surrender unto him, when you're still and when you read the word of God, you are able to let him take your confusion and those fears that you might have. You know, sometimes we have the fear of unknown in our lives. You don't know what is going to happen the next moment in your life. That fear, when you're still, God is saying that he will, and you let God move you in these times of fear, he's able to fight your battles. Amen? And in all that, remember that whatever your struggle is, lay it before the Lord. Amen? Wow. Whatever your struggle is, lay it before the Lord. What is that struggle you have in you? Are you struggling at your workplace? You feel that the pressure is too much and you can't even fight for yourself. People are against you in your workplace. Just know that whatever struggle you have, lay it before the Lord and he'll be able to fight your battle. Amen? Then we'll see the next step. How can we allow God to fight our battle? How can we allow God to fight our battles? Before we had learned, how do we let God fight our battles? Now let's see how we can allow God to fight our battles. Number one, by not being afraid or dismayed, for the battle is not ours, but God's. Amen? Yeah. Do not be afraid. And I tell myself every day, I'm not supposed to be afraid or dismayed about anything in my life. When sickness comes, I'm not afraid because the battle is not mine, but God. And that happens. You're able to get this strength when you're still. And we have all seen what is stillness and how to be still in the presence of God. When you have this prayer in your heart every day and you're afraid, God gives you the strength to overcome this, and you're able to understand that the battle is not yours, but God's. Amen? So don't fight for yourself. Let God fight for you. The battle is not yours. Whatever you're going through is not yours, but it is for God. When you have learned that we should take it before God, when you take it before God, he's able to fight your battles. Number two, you take it to God. Take it to Jesus. Take it to Jesus. He is a friend that's well known. You have no other such a friend or brother. Take it to Jesus alone. Yes, that is what he's telling us in that song. And we have learned that when you listen to worship songs, you're able to let God fight your battles. And you have seen it with that song, that take it to Jesus. And here we have been told, take it all to Jesus. Take it all to God. Whatever is in your heart, that battle that you feel that is stressing you, just take it to God. And you're able to take it to God. Even if you don't know how to pray, you can sing that song. Take it, it is a hymn, it's a common hymn song. Take it to Jesus, just that, and he's able to hear your prayers. Then, number three, you seek him. He says, seek he first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Amen? Everything that you need, that peace in your heart, that stillness, when you seek him first, seeking God first, not your job, not your comfort, not money, seeking God first, he will be able to fight your battles. Even if you, when he gives you all that, when you have seeked him, he'll be able to fight even the battles that will come your way. Amen? Then number four, you separate some time. Sometimes when I was reading this point, as I was writing it down, I asked myself, do I even take time to be with God. Not in my home, not anywhere, but creating time, going to a place where he can speak unto me, where he can speak unto us. Do you create time for God? Ask yourself that. You can create time for him. You can just even, if it's walking into a forest where it's safe, you take time with God. Some of us even don't know prayer centers around us. There are so many. You can go to them, even if it's for 2 hours. Pray to God. You have some time with God. So that when your battles come, he'll be able to fight for you, because you will have that strength to overcome all that. Then you worship first. Worship. All the answers we have, they have been recorded in songs. Take it to Jesus. He's a friend that will know. Be still and know that I'm God. Worship. Worship. Learn songs of worship. Listen to them. You're able to grow and you're able to let it go and let God in your life. Then you present your need. Sometimes God doesn't fight our battles because we don't let them known to him. Do you tell God what you need? Do I tell God what I need? Let's ponder on that. Let's always make our needs known to God, and he'll be able to fight our battles. Then, at last, you tell him that you can't solve your problem. Inform God, I can't do it. I can't do it on my own. If you don't come into my life, I cannot do it. Then it is promising us, wait. It just doesn't happen instantly. You will not just tell God, God fight my battle, and he fight it immediately. Sometimes you have to wait. Wait upon God. Wait upon him to have his way. Sometimes he delays for his glory to be seen over our lives. You might be sick and you're feeling that I've waited upon God. I've told God, God, fight this battle of my sickness, but it is taking time. But have you ever tried to let God speak unto you at that time? Have you ever tried to just let it go and be still and inform God that, God, yes, I'm in this pain, but I'm trusting upon your process, and he's able to fight your battles. Amen. Then in that, we will hear what Exodus 14, verse 14, what the scripture says, verse 14. I have short formed it, and it says, the Lord will fight for you, and you have only to be silent. Amen? The Lord will fight for you, and you have only to be silent. This Exodus 14 from verse 1, it's when the Israelites were leaving from Pharaoh's hand, and Pharaoh had decided to follow them. And when they turned back and saw that Pharaoh was behind them, they started being afraid. But Moses told them, the Lord will fight for you, and you have only to be silent. And when they listened to this, they were able to take instructions, and they were able to cross, and they were able to go to the other side, and they saw God victory over their life. Amen? And with all that, hope you've learned something, and hope I've learned something. I want us to make a declaration this morning, if you want, but I will also make it. It's there on the screen, and it says, in all things, I will let God fight for me. Amen? Tell it to yourself. In all things, everyone, let's go. In all things, I will let God fight for me. Amen? And that is the word of God. Amen? Let's bow our head for a word of prayer. Almighty, ever-living God, thank you because of the teaching we have had today on being still and letting you fight our battles, oh God. Sometimes we have these battles in our lives. Sometimes we feel that we cannot make it on our own. Sometimes we rely on our own understanding, and we don't surrender it all unto you, oh God. But this day you have taught us how to let it go to you. You have taught us how to pray, going and creating time for you, worshiping you, praising you, and we'll be able to fight our needs, oh God. Thank you because of all the battles in our lives. May it be the sickness that we might have in our lives. May it be the job that we are seeking from you. May it be the things that are surrounding our lives, about Father God. How we pray that, Lord, you will speak unto us to be still and let you fight our battles, O God. The battle is not ours, but it is yours, O God. Just as you fought the battles for even the people of Israelites as they were coming out, over Father God, of their slavery, O God. We are asking you to fight our battles of our lives, Abba Father God. We ask and we desire to know you and the power of your name. Help us to always meditate upon your word. Help us to live upon your word. Help us to be good stewards of you, O God, and to always know that in all things that you will make it happen for us. And it is in Jesus' name that we do pray, believe, and trust in your holy name. I will be still and know you are God. I will be still and know you are God. Let's go. I will be still and know you are God. I will be still and know you are God. Amen.
Are you weary? Are you heavy-hearted? Tell it to Jesus. Tell it to Jesus. Are you grieving over just departed? Tell it to Jesus alone. Tell it to Jesus. Tell it to Jesus. He is a friend. That's where I know. You know other such a friend or brother. Tell it to Jesus alone.
Thank you so much, Hannah, for the beautiful teaching. Now we welcome the people of Nazareth to bring their matter and their presentation.
Oh.
nanza ngaji.
Taro raira dimo one 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 uria gaye kaga ne one gaya reha muena doake taro raira dimo one one uria gaye kaga one one ya. Kuma toi wa moga po wa mwadhani.
Ayari hamwena nyuake.
Waigera goroi nere uno wadhika.
Ayari hamwena nyuake.
Irazi mona shoi kiura tabura.
Ayari hamwena nyuake.
Taro raira dimo one 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 uria gaye kete one one gaya
amwena nduake.
Taro raira dimo one 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 uria gaye kete one one gaya amwena nduake. Meshe ito gai nyara dimite, ari hamwe nadwake. Wedo nage keno itura gana idwi,
ari hamwe nadwake.
Shiana shito nasione shiazikaga,
ari hamwe nadwake.
Taro raira dimo one one one
uria gaye kete
one one
gaya rihamwe nadwake.
Taro raira dimo
one
one one
uria gaye kete one gaya rihamwe nadwake.
Mawe mamoko nyara dhimite
gayari hamwe nadwake.
Makobe maitono kuyorerera
gayari hamwe nadwake.
Tohone tengoro na mere itu
gayari hamwe nadwake.
Taro dimo
one
one one
uria gaye kete
one one
gaya rihamwe nadwake.
This is the Nazareth group, and we have a presentation which we are now going to take. Kahedndo, if it is possible, you can project it.
Nidoka kiugo ine kiaria theru, aria mahota neiro negai, aria matuete matua kurogama, na kiugo kiama na kia odigu, aria matio ego tiganeria, majiaro genda mati ganageria, I am a tio ego tiganeria, magiaro genda mati tiganageria. I am a hana, wadani wao, I am a tio ego hotoneta ke. I
Wow, that's wonderful. We really thank God for the cell group and for the great work that has been done today. We want to celebrate our youths for work well done. Amasikweli, it is work well done. We really grateful and we thank God that we have people whom we can entrust the work of the Lord to. So may the Lord bless you. Let us all kneel down. Wale ambao wanaweza kupiga magoti. This lady is big. Tusonge, tupate nafasi. So that we can pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we are before your presence this morning. We have a reason to thank you, Father, to worship you, to adore you, O Jehovah God, to give you praise and honor. For Lord God Almighty, you have taken us this far. Were it not for your hand, we'd not be where we are today. But God, we have seen your hand upon our lives. You have been so faithful to us. You've been so caring. You've been so loving. What a mighty God we serve. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we approach the throne of grace this morning as we celebrate the dear cell group of Nazareth. For how, Lord, you have seen them through in everything that they have been doing. Thank you for them taking time to prepare for this great day. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you so much for the services that they have led us in this sanctuary this morning. The leading of the service, the lessons, the presentations, and also the word of God that has come to us so strongly that we need to be still and know that you are the Lord. We allow you to fight our battles because there is no battle, God, that you have ever fought and you are defeated. And therefore, Lord, we want to trust you. Gracious Father, we want to thank you for they have come into the house of the Lord with thanksgiving. Of the many blessings that, God, you have given unto them, they have stretched a hand to them that are less privileged. Heavenly Father, we pray that God, you are going to fill their baskets, because God, they have given from their hearts, from their resources, oh God. We pray as you accept the, whatever they have given this morning as matega, oh God, you are going to bless them, and they shall never suffer lack, because God, you shall be with them in their farms, in their businesses, and even their places of work. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you, because God, you know how to reward. We pray that going, God, you are going to reward them according to your riches in glory, and help them never to forget of your greatness and of your goodness all the days of their lives. We pray that, God, you are going to bless each and every family that is represented this morning. And we pray that, God, as they go back to their homes, they will find your presence in their homes, and they will enjoy living in dominion and the peace that comes from you. Father, walk with them and bless them. In Jesus' name, we do pray and give thanks. Can now the whole church stand as we pray for the offering? Heavenly Father, we thank you so much because you are the owner of everything. You have given us, Lord God, and that is why we are able to come into your sanctuary not empty-handed, but with a free will offering. Also, we want to thank you, Lord, for the development that we are undertaking in this church. You have been so faithful from the time we started the correction of the stone. And God, we want to thank you so much because we've never gotten tired and we are continuing with the project. We pray that, God Almighty, you are going to receive everything that we have brought into your house this morning. And we pray that, God, whatever we have brought out of our clean hearts shall be a sacrifice, that you speak great things in our lives. We pray that this altar is going to speak to every life that is here this morning for the honor and the glory of your name. Accept it, O God, and continue enlarging our boundaries, that we may not suffer lack, that we may have enough for our needs, and also a portion for the ministry of the gospel. Father, we pray that you continue blessing us in our going out and in our coming in. Shower the abundance of your blessings upon our lives, for this is our prayer of faith in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Okay, thank you very much. Nazareth, as you sit, may the Lord God bless you, and thank you very, very much for the beautiful service. And also, you have really tried to keep time, and we thank God for that. Before I give the benediction, let's be seated for a while. I just want to remind all of us of our forthcoming harambe on the Saba of this month. And I know because God is faithful, he will continue blessing us. Our pay bill is always open. And I want to thank God for the people who have already started depositing their contributions for the harambe. And you are free to deposit your contributions and then liaise with your cell group leaders so that you can have your register updated. Also, remember, we are having our 40th celebrations since the inception of this diocese. It was started in the year 1984, so it is now 40 years old, and we are having some activities for the 40th anniversary. We are having a marathon in the month of November. And this marathon is for people between 18 years of age to 65, around there, though they will run different races. And we have been requested to request anybody who feels that he or she would want to join in the marathon kindly. We are registering with 1,000 shillings. Therefore, you can register with our evangelist so that you can be included in the marathon. Also, we are having our Golden Jubilee for our church this year. It will be on the 24th of November, and we are kindly requesting for all those who would want to have their marriages ceremonized on that day, or those who want to have their marriage vows renewed on that day, kindly register with the church elders so that we can be able to make the necessary arrangements. We do not want to just come and have a service and then go. We would want to have something going on. For all of us who are blessed, and they are 50 this year, those of us, not me, those of us who are born in the year 1984, we are celebrating 50 years. Kindly, I believe you can be able to come up to join up together. Then we will come as a group to celebrate God giving us life for half a century. It is not a joke, isn't it? So wale watu wa 1984, oh, 74, kuna mix up ya diocese na yetu. Sasa hii ni yetu. Wale watu wa 1974, wakati lile kanisa lilikonsekretiwa, dio tutaongana sisi wote, tujifanya group moja, tuwe na activity moja, ile ambao tutapresent as we celebrate half a century in this life. Mwleshi diego ikaranduthu century ni miaka menini? Gideti miaka meige. So let us join together. Jane, ujue vire mta. Nejue wedure wa 74. Wewe iguru wa hau. No, aliatua shielilo 74. Let us register with Jane first. Then from that group, we will get a leader. Isn't it? So that we can at least have something to do on that day. We come and celebrate 50 proudly because God has brought us this far. Niwe kulia dumashi ya liru wana magekua. Tuka tushoke liye gaigado ni goto kinye miaka igana. Miaka mirogo etano. Nye dire waho negereti ya hau. Na nidira shoke liye gaigado because he has walked with me for so many years. And I am very grateful. I'm almost 70 now. And I thank God for that. But anyway, let us join as a team. We come do a presentation together. I believe in a group we make a pale do ikona service on Sunday. Yeah? Ebu, wherever you are seated, our university and college students, can you kindly stand up? Ona koroga manowe ratafadhali, mutiroga me inaihenya. Haya, that group mkitoka mkutane pale nje, before you leave, give me the program for Sunday. Sawa sawa? Yeah, so that tutaigia, then we are somewhere there. We do not know where to start and where to end. Let us all stand on our feet. Unto your able hands, Lord God Almighty, we surrender to you, being so happy to know that we have a God who fights our battles. To know we have a God who is concerned about our well-being and everything that happens around us. Heavenly Father, we pray that you may give us a heart that desires to love you, to serve you, to live for you all the days of our lives. In all our endeavors, O God, we want to trust you. You are a friend like no other. We pray that God, as even we come to the end of the month of May, God, you may help our hearts to celebrate your greatness and your faithfulness. And we pray that God, you are going to watch over us even during this last week of the month of May, our going out and our coming in. We want to put all our worries, all our cares unto you. For Lord, you cares for us. Walk with us and bless us. For it is in Jesus' name we do pray and give thanks. And now may the peace of God that surpasses the understanding of men keep your body and your soul in eternal peace The blessings of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you, remain with you now and forevermore. Amen. May the Lord God be with you. May he bless you and may he keep you. Before we leave, I have just remembered this week we shall be having Holy Communion for the aged and the sick. We shall have it on Wednesday, Judea, Gariri, Jerusalem. And then on Friday, we will have Macedonia, Bethlehem, and Nazareth. Thursday, senior citizens, we shall be having a Holy Communion service. Thank you and have a blessed week.
On behalf of the Nazareth people, I feel honored to have led you today. My name is Jenny Gikonyo, and our recessional hymn is Hymn 18. Have a nice week and a happy new month. Choir.
Guide me, O